air pollution is a serious problem in London. But somehow it's like a top-down approach. I think we want to have a kind of support by the general public. So they say, should we kind of enable our PhD student to go to the school and teach the school student to build their own device and monitor their schools?
The idea about this project was to go to the schools and work with young students from key stage 3 to develop some kind of sensors that would enable us to measure the air pollution in that area. So it was about getting to the community and working with the kids in order to get this kind of data that we know is really important to their quality of life.
The students got involved in designing a sensor and thinking about how that would run within the school, but of course they had all the local knowledge about the schools and how things might work there, so decided where to situate that sensor, figured out how to get it running, and worked together really well as a team, and they've been producing data since before the summer, so that's great.
We had a quite a lot of lessons, and we learned about how to use a Raspberry Pi, and we wanted them to see how much pollution and how safe the air is where we're based. I found it really fun. I didn't really know a lot about engineering. I thought it was just about fixing vehicles and stuff, but now I've learned a lot more and I might want to pursue a career in the future.
The project began by a little device, a little radio module we designed in-house in my research team, can provide very large, long coverage. So that means it can be used for a lot of sensor networks. And it's very easy to connect, and once we connect the sensor data will be sent to a server.
Well, we're trying to test out the air pollution inside the plant, like our school, around the area we are, and then how much like pollution there is in there. Put it like where the lab used to be, close to the roof, but then we had to move the lab to the second floor, so we were able to go there. I enjoyed it when we had to look around the school to put the right place, because like we had to explain which one would be better.
We need to get like these high abstract level things to like the pupils level and explain things to them in a more like easy and understandable way, considering their basic knowledge about what we're doing. And so that was really good training. And the other thing as well was more about how can we transfer this technology from the lab and our research to like the daily life, and also introduce it in a way that make it more believable and touches their daily life, rather than doing something like far-fetched and they just hear about it without interacting mainly with it.
The industrial strategy gives kind of key areas that are going to be really important for the future, and of course the young people are the people that are going to tackle those challenges. So we wanted to make sure that the project was a genuine one, something that genuinely is a problem in London and needs development. And the industrial strategy looks at different areas, including the one around monitoring and air pollution that is developing.
It would be nice for more schools to take up this kind of project, because I think it's good at both raising awareness about problems of air pollution in the areas that they live and work in, but it's also good to promote the STEM subjects to children who might not previously have considered it.
I think it would be great to take part in a project like this, because it's so fun and it's very interesting.
What we want to do in the future is we engage this time 10 PhD students. So next time we'll have another 10 PhD students. One PhD student engage another 10, then we have 100 people. Then we can cover larger area. Our inspiration, I think they will be part of the project.